Red Hat announced RHEL 10 this week at the Red Hat Summit. So Red Hat Enterprise Linux 10 is here. This release is massive with huge implications for the future of Linux systems. And there's a lot of exciting stuff to talk about. It's AI powered, it's quantum resilient, and it's cloud native. I attended this year's Red Hat Summit and it was so much fun and I learned so much. And yet I think I only barely scratched the surface of the event. That's the only downside of these kinds of events. There's so much to see and do and learn that you would be lucky to leave with maybe 20% of experiencing it. Still, I try to get as much as possible from it, and we are working on some videos to show our experiences. So RHEL 10 is here, and it's got AI baked right into the shell. They say that tapping into decades of Red Hat Enterprise Linux specific knowledge, it assists with the tasks from troubleshooting common issues to best practices for managing complex IT estates. This empowers both newer and experienced IT professionals to manage vast Red Hat Enterprise Linux environments with greater efficiency by bringing AI-powered help straight to the command line in RHEL 10. So what are we talking about? Well, we're talking about Red Hat LightSpeed. LightSpeed is so cool. It turns sysadmin tasks into simple, natural language prompts, bridging the Linux skills gap with generative AI. It is a very cool feature that has tons of great options you can do with, you know, saying something you wanted to do something and it'll tell you how to do it and show you, and then you can learn from that process. And it also can talk to you in pirate speak. You'll see what I mean in one of the videos that releases next week, but it's pretty awesome. Security is getting a serious future-proofing with this as well. Red Hat Enterprise Linux 10 leads the industry as the first enterprise Linux distribution to integrate National Institute of Standards and Technology, or NIST, standards for post-quantum cryptography. This gives organizations a proactive defense against the harvest now, decrypt later attacks by building in quantum-resistant encryption. This is a huge deal. And Red Hat's not done there. They're also transforming how OS images are built and deployed. They have added image mode for RHEL. This lets you deploy your OS as a bootsy image to your hardware, virtual machine, or cloud, and then layer your app on top of that. That's a far less complex operation than traditional package deployments, and it gives developers and image maintainers a common experience and total control over their environment. Image mode reduces configuration drift and unifies tools for managing both applications and infrastructure. RHEL 10 isn't just about what Linux can do today. It's engineered where enterprise IT is heading to. Whether you're deploying on-prem or in the cloud or on the edge, Red Hat is raising the bar. And if you want to keep it RHEL, you can check the links in the show notes to find more information.